has not been a friendly Parliament week. Having started with shocking news of the death of Oyam North Count MP, retired Colonel Charles Engola, who doubled as the Minister of State for Labour and Employment. Engola was shot dead by his bodyguard, Wilson Sabiti, who later committed suicide, leaving Parliament in shock.
Private Sabiti Wilson opened the fire at the ADC first and ran after the other bodyguard, who was trying to remove the flag, but also shooting. And in the process, the minister tried to get out of the vehicle, and then he was shot dead instantly.
Maybe he saw him as a representative of the government, or whatever the case might be. But this is a clarion call. Let's begin to take care of these people.
Not even the grief could stop Parliament from reconsidering the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023, which was bounced back by the President. 340 MPs voted in favour of the bill against one dissenting member. Before passing the bill, MPs reconsidered some issues raised by the President while returning the bill to Parliament. Among them was by amending Clause 213 to create further clarity on the purpose and intention of the bill to criminalize sexual acts committed by persons of the same sex rather than punishing a person based on their perceived sexuality and physical appearance.
Be considered by this August House. Those in favor will say aye, and those against will say nay.
That we should not accept the intimidation which is coming from the Western world to us as a country.
Can I tell you, rest your fears. Fight the corruption, we have enough money here.
From the top, but not from down.
The brawl between the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, and the Deputy Attorney General, Jackson Kafuzi, is not worthy this week. Kafuzi is accused of depicting Parliament in bad light when he told the President that he was coerced to agree with Parliament in the first passing of the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023.
And from today onwards, you will not come to this house and defend any bill. You will not do it under my leadership.
I don't know, Speaker, would it be procedurally right to invite the Deputy Attorney General here to come and apologize?
So if someone says you forced him or her, it is improper, it is uncalled for, and we need this person to appear in person to explain why he carried out that kind of communication that has brought all this. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Right, Honorable Speaker, we sincerely apologize for that. The Office of the Attorney General will continue to work closely with Parliament to ensure that this doesn't happen again.
The issue of security officers and RDCs disrupting political activities organized by members of Parliament in their districts also made rounds on the floor of Parliament as MPs condemned the vice of brutality used by police to frustrate their activities. Although the Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, presented a statement on the matter with actions taken on perpetrators, it wasn't enough to convince Parliament, as the Speaker, Anita Among, assigned a Committee of Presidential Affairs to investigate the conduct of MPs.
All your RDCs who are defiant must be brought to book. And we want a report in this House on which RDCs you have brought to book.
The Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, has also had the High Education Students Financing Board on spot over selective distribution of loans offered to students. The committee discovered that, although the program was meant to benefit the vulnerable students, most beneficiaries come from well-off districts, especially from Western Uganda.
Majority of the beneficiaries are from Western Uganda. Now, I don't have a problem with Western Uganda. I have some relatives from there.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.